Hi everyone and welcome back to the Organized Notebook. In this video, we wanted to talk about the differences, strengths, and weaknesses of Trello versus Notion. And both tools are used widely as project management tools, and we thought that it would be interesting to compare the two. So in case that you're trying to decide which one is better for you, or if you already use one of them and want to try the other, it could be an interesting comparison. Let's first start by looking at Trello's strengths. So when you first open a Trello board, you'll notice just how simple everything is. So there are these lists and there are cards inside each list, and you can categorize your cards based on lists by dragging them around. So it really just feels like you have a board and you're moving around cards. So let's say you had sticky notes and you just move a sticky note from one area of a board to another. So everything works very intuitively. So let's say you have card one, which is a task, and you can move it to doing and you can move it to done very easily. And each of these lists can also be moved around if you actually wanted to do here instead of doing. And you can also add another list very easily as well. So things work just very simply in Trello. So if we go ahead and go to Notion, you'll notice that it does look a bit similar. You can move cards around and so on. But actually, if you just start by typing slash board to make a new board-based database, and you click plus new database, you'll notice that you actually cannot move the lists here. So this to-do, no matter how hard you try, you can't really drag it. And actually, in order to change those settings, you have to go to the three dots here, go to layout, and then you have to go to the group by and change it to manual sort. So in that sense, Notion is a little bit harder to use, that there it's not as intuitive on how things work compared to Trello. So if we go back to Trello, you'll see that it's just drag and drop everything pretty much. So it's just very easy. And the next thing we wanted to show you is the button automation in Trello. So if we click a card and we go to the automation here, you'll notice that adding new buttons is very easy. You can just click plus add button. And let's say you wanted to create a button that's going to just move a card somewhere else. So you could do move card two, and we can move it to the list done. So move card to done. And you can just add the button like this, and you'll see that move cards are done. It's right there and it's done. So if we go to Notion, on the other hand, what's difficult is that to create buttons, which are possible now, it's only possible within the page. So you actually have to change the database template if you want it to be reflected in every single page of the database. So if we go to Trello, you'll notice that card one has this button here, move card to done. Card two also has the same button here, and the whole thing has that button when you make it in one card. But with Notion, let's say that we make a button here, slash button, and we decide to make a button that edits the page in only this page. And we edit the property, which is the status, so that it's done. And we'll call it move to done. Then if we click this button, it's going to move it to done. And that's exactly the same as what happened with the Trello, except that if we click on card two, there is no button inside here. So what you actually have to do is make sure to add the button through the sub template for that database by clicking plus new. So it's just a little more steps in order to accomplish the same thing. And let's go back to Trello. So that's about the button automations. And then the biggest thing that we think is great with Trello is the checkboxes for each task. So it's just built in and works really easily. So if we go to card one and we wanted to add items to a checklist, it's super easy. And you can add multiple checklists as well. So let's say we add item one, item two, item three, and things are built in, like assigning these items to people or the due date for each one and so on. And if we click these, they get completed like this, and you see that on the card. So this is just very easy to use. But let's say in Notion, when we want to do the same thing, you actually have to build two databases for that. So we have the main project board, and then we have the table for tasks, and you have to relate the two databases to each other. And then you have to actually add a formula. And we just pre-made this just to show you, but if we click the formula and edit property and edit the formula, you'll see that this is what you have to do in order to show the same sort of progress bar like this. And if you wanted to add multiple checklists, it wouldn't really be possible, because unless they were both grouped together by separate task types. So you are kind of stuck with this, and you have to add this kind of formula in order to accomplish the same thing. So in that sense, it's possible, but it's not really built in the way that Trello has here, like this. And the other thing is that with Trello, they have these power-ups, which seems very useful. So if we click plus add power-ups, you'll see a list of all of these things that could make your Trello experience easier and more useful. So there's things like quickly create new cards on your Trello board without leaving your Gmail inbox, or all these things you can do straight out of your Trello workspace or board. But if we go to Notion, you can't just add a power up like that here. You could do some kind of automation tool that's a third party, but it's not just like you can do it inside here. So if we go back to Trello, then now we wanted to also talk about the labels. So labels are kind of like tags on each card. And if we go to labels, you'll see that actually there is a whole bunch of colors with Trello. So you can choose from a wide variety of colors. But if we go to Notion, and let's say we wanted to add something similar, which is called a multi-select in Notion, and we have label one here, and we wanted to add label two, and so on. Well, if we click here, which is where you change the color, you'll notice that these are the only options for Notion's colors. So let's say that you have more labels than the number of colors available, then you actually have to start using duplicate labels colors, which can get really confusing on the Notion board view. But with Trello, at least there is this many colors, so you could at least have this many labels without having duplicate colors, which makes it really easy to visualize the board. And it actually happens to us sometimes that we have more multi-select in Notion than the colors available, and it's a bit annoying that we have to just use duplicates of the same color. And we also wanted to point out that it has this enable colorblind friendly mode right here, which is easy to click and add on. So we think that this is also a really nice feature that Trello added to this. So that's basically it for Trello strengths. So as you can see, it's just very intuitive and easy to use. And now let's go to Notion and talk about Notion strengths while we compare it to Trello. So the first thing we wanted to talk about is that Notion has really versatile properties. So if we click on a card, you'll notice that there's so many things you can add here. So if we click on plus add property, you can add so many things: select, multi-select, status, date, person. And it's not really limited how many things or how many times you can add something like this to each card of this database. But instead, if we go to Trello, you'll see that you can add more fields through custom fields, but this is actually blocked by the paid plan. So it's not like you can access this if it's free, but if you did pay for it, then even then, these are your options with Trello. And it does have a number property that you can add, but it's very limited. So even if you did add this, it's not like you can do calculations in here. But with Notion, it's actually very possible that you could add two numbers and add them together all within the card. And it's all free. So that's really nice about Notion. And the other thing is that the database views are very versatile, and it's not blocked by a paywall or anything. So if we click layout, you'll notice that they have all of these options on how you display the data that's in your board view. And in Trello, you also need to have a paid plan for this, but you can look at it in table and calendar, but it's quite limited in the sense that it's really built to be this kind of board-based system with Trello. And Notion is meant to be used in a way that you store data, but it can also be versatile in the sense that you can also use it for project and task management this way as well. And the other thing is that each card can be used to write content inside. So this is very big in that with Trello, it's just not built to be used that way. But with Notion, you can actually just start writing an entire blog article inside of this page if you really wanted to. And if we go to Trello, you'll see that the only space you get to write is in this description. And it's not really built to be your place to write content. And here also with that is that you actually have the option to add an upgrade in Notion called Notion AI. And we'll leave the link to that in the description. And if you do decide to upgrade, you'll be supporting us at no cost to you. But we also wanted to just share this because it's just so useful. So let's say that you're using this board view in Notion to keep track of blog articles that you're crafting from to do, in progress to done. And you're also writing it in the same card. So that's actually possible with Notion. So let's say you have a blog article here and you can easily ask AI to just write you an outline. So you would press /AI and you can ask it to write a short blog article about Trello, let's say. And AI starts writing. So just being able to access some kind of assisting tool through AI within a card is super useful for Notion if you have Notion AI. But with Trello, there's really no option to add AI here. So, and it's not really useful either to have it. So it's just some kind of added benefit with Notion, or if you're using it as also your place to add content to, then Notion could be a better choice for you. And finally, what we wanted to talk about is the price plan of both Notion and Trello. So if we go to Trello's plan, you'll notice that you have to pay $10 if you want workspace views. So this seems quite limited that you don't have this in the free plan. And if we go to Notion's pricing plan, it's $8 per user per month for the plus plan, which is probably what most people need anyway. So in that sense, it might be more economical to use Notion if you want multiple database views, for example. So it's something to consider to check the pricing plan as well when you're deciding which one is better for you. And that's basically it. So let us know what you think about Notion versus Trello. Have you used both of these tools? What are your thoughts on it? And let us know if anything was confusing or you still have any questions, and we hope to see you in the next video.